Hey everyone, Drama Cult is back with part 5 of the spoilers for the Thai BL Oxygen. Have you checked out the previous parts? If not, do check it out. If you like our content, do subscribe to us and smash the bell icon. Also, hit the like button for this video and leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Now, let's get into the narration. You can turn on CC for English subtitles. The one with the strange phone call. After spending time alone on the beach, Solo and Yi return to the night party at the resort. They find everyone drunk. Solo gets dragged off to play guitar by the poolside. Solo starts playing his guitar, but he does not take his eyes off of Yi. Yi couldn't help but blush and he avoids Solo's eyes. Yi's friends start reenacting the public confession between Solo and Yi. Seeing this, Solo starts laughing. Later, almost everyone becomes unconscious. Solo then approaches Yi, asking him if he wants to drink. Yi then informs Solo that he does not enjoy drinking and that he would prefer staying sober than having a hangover on the next day. Solo then tries to be a good boyfriend and says he would stay sober along with Yi. Yi notices the clear disappointment on Solo's face. Yi understands that Solo wants him to give his permission for Solo to drink. After teasing Solo for some time, Yi agrees to it, which turns Solo into the cute husky that he is usually around Yi. Solo then gets a call on his phone. He moves away to take the call. Solo turned moody after that conversation. When he gets back, Solo asks Yi if he really wants to be with him, and if he agrees to it, then Solo would never let Yi go. Solo wanted to get a confirmation from Yi. After being dumbfounded for a few minutes by the sudden change in the tone of Solo's voice, Yi starts to reply, but Solo forbids him and smiles. Yi was confident that it won't be long before he starts loving Solo with all his heart. He was almost there already. Yi then tells Solo to just wait for him a bit and then he will truly get to feel Yi's love. Solo receives another phone call which makes him agitated. He moves away to talk over the phone and he gets all angry. Yi gets concerned. Kao then informs Yi that this has happened a few times before and he always gets really upset after getting a phone call from someone. Kao and Jedi were never able to calm him down and Kao asks Yi to talk to Solo to calm him down. Kao then adds that Solo is really hot-tempered when he encounters any serious problem and asks Yi to take care of himself too while dealing with Solo during such times. Yi then assures Kao that he will take care of it. Solo does not notice Yi approaching him. He continues having the heated conversation over his phone and then frustratedly throws his phone away. Solo sees Yi and calms down a bit. Yi then hugs Solo. Solo then pleads with Yi to not ask him about the phone call and that he will tell him about it when he is ready. Yi agrees to it and comforts him. The one with the second birthday surprise for Yi. Even after 1 week after coming back from the beach, Solo kept on sulking. Yi tried hard to not notice it as Solo was going about his day like he normally does, but it's just that he was sulking all the while. To cheer Solo up, Yi proposes that he would stay at Solo's place. This certainly elevates Solo's mood. Yi collects all the essentials from his dorm and goes straight to Solo's condo. Solo then invites Yi to his bedroom to check out Yi's birthday present. Yi gets surprised as he thought the performance and the confession at the beach were his presents. Yi gets really excited as no one really did anything special for him on any of his previous birthdays. Yi opens a closet that Solo points at and finds lots and lots of clothes, every kind of clothing a mad might need. Yi chides Solo saying it's a bit too much to buy him these many clothes. Solo then says the clothes are for Yi to wear at Solo's condo. He adds that it was not just clothes that he brought for Yi. Everything in the condo has been changed to accommodate Yi's requirements. Yi realizes that this was Solo asking him to move in with him. Yi then responds by asking Solo if it wouldn't be of inconvenience to him if Yi was always there with Solo as they were still not a couple. Solo then hugs Yi and pleads with him to be his boyfriend. Solo adds, since Yi would be joining for his internship real soon, this was the only way for them to be together or else they wouldn't be able to meet each other as much as they would want to. Yi concurs and decides on moving out of his dorm. The one with a strange phone call again. Solo's phone starts ringing while he was practicing. He asks Yi to pick up the call. It was from an unsaved number. Gee answers, and it was not a voice that he recognized. The strange voice asks him if it was Gee who was answering the phone. Gee never expected the strange voice to know about him. The person on the phone asks Gee to inform Solo if he disobeys his father's orders and refuses to contact him, he would fly to Thailand and that might result in some adverse consequences for Solo. Due to the honorific that the person used, Gee deduces that the person on the phone might be someone who works for Solo's father. The conversation ends and it dawns on Gee that he does not know much about Solo. A sudden fear creeps in on him, the fear of Gee losing Solo somehow. The one when Solo opens up to Gee. After staying silent for a long time, Gee informs Solo about the person on the phone. Solo gets frustrated. Gee holds on to Solo's hand and slowly nudges him to open up so that Gee would be able to help him in whatever way possible. After some hesitation, Solo begins to talk. He faults himself for being selfish and getting close to Gee, despite knowing the troubles that Gee will have to endure because of it. He lists two reasons why Gee shouldn't be involved with him. One, because of the kind of person Solo's dad is, Gee might end up getting hurt. And second, due to his mother, about whom he was not prepared to talk about just yet. Solo continues to talk about the person on the phone, Jay. Jay was the person who looked after Solo after his mom passed away. Solo considered Jay to be a friend, a brother, and his family, as his dad was never around to look after him. 2 years ago, Solo's dad asked Jay to accompany him to look after his business abroad. Jay then left Solo without any hesitation. This made Solo realize that Jay was not his real friend and he became close to Solo just because his father ordered him to. This hurt Solo deeply and he became alone again, and that's when he decided on living his own life and moved to Thailand. Now that his father is getting involved with his life again, he is scared that he would take away the one happiness that he has now in his life, which is Gee. After Gee assures Solo that he will be there for him no matter what, Solo agrees to talk to Jay. Jay then informs Solo about his dad's plans to come to Thailand in the following month and that, after his studies, his dad expects Solo to take charge of their business in Thailand. Jay advises Solo to protect Gee by not getting involved with him. This frustrates Solo, but Gee calms him down. Gee then decides on staying with Solo despite the troubles that he might have to face because of it. Solo and Gee decide on actually being together as a couple. Solo then falls asleep in Gee's arms, and that's when Gee acknowledges to himself that Solo is truly Gee's happiness. Guys, we have come to the end of part 5. Are you excited for the next part? Do wait for it. That's it for now, guys. Catch you with the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.